Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Gateway Community College.
All right, I want to welcome everybody to Bishop Connolly High School, the site of today's NJCAA Region 21 matchup. This is Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. Bristol Community College Bayhawks in their white uniforms with the green trimming, going against Gateway in their royal blue with the gold numbers. I'm David Cardozo. I'm alongside with me is the Portuguese Cowboy himself, Mr. Craig Salvador. What's going on, Craig?
Not much. Good to be back. You know, missed last game, but I had to take some time off after that heart attack we called the Super Bowl.
Oh, my God. What an unbelievable game, man. I still can't believe it. I'm still like, I don't know.
I know, it's crazy.
I'm still looking at every highlight, every sound effects. But here we go. Tip off from Bishop Connolly. And just like that, right at the top, that's number 15, Katrina Depew off the tip.
It's a good job by Gateway right out of the gates, scoring 2 points. And
if you're just joining us, Katia Luna, one of the Bristol Community College Bayhawks starters, sang the national anthem, and she did a bang-up job. Yep. Gateway in zone. Here's Megan Parrish. Deja Easton back. There's Deborah Banks. Jumper, no good.
Almost got it. It's good to see Deja Easton back after we said she had her head injury a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, it didn't look good. A couple weeks ago, Deja Easton went out with a head injury. And it said that she had a concussion, but she's back. Good to see her back. Kind of deepens out the bench a little bit. Extra body doesn't hurt.
It's kind of interesting seeing Shannon Rosenstiel on the bench to start this game.
Well, maybe that will allow her to stay in the game longer. She can come off the bench. She's been in foul trouble a lot this season.
This is very true.
We haven't done a game in a little while, Craig. We had a game that we were scheduled to do a game on Tuesday, and due to inclement weather, we got snowed out.
Yeah, I wasn't
imagine
sure
how depressing it would be right now, you know, if the Patriots had a loss and we're getting all this snow.
Yeah.
Be
then
like,
you're just trapped in your house still crying.
Still crying, exactly.
Yeah. I was crying during the halftime show, not because of Lady Gaga, but just
I
because.
I was crying during the comeback. I was like, oh, my God, I can't believe this.
Oh, Contractor just lost it, but Easton did a good job recovering.
Contractor getting the start today. Oh, nice move by call steps.
Almost looked like they were going to call a foul, but nope, steps, so no basket. Of course, now with the Super Bowl ending, football season is officially over. It's really basketball's time to really shine now as we go into the playoffs pretty soon.
It's all basketball now. Yep. Especially with these girls.
That's a travel. Yep.
With the women and the men, this is a stretch. This is like the stretch push right now. We're getting towards the postseason.
Getting to nitty-gritty territory.
Yeah.
Luna puts up a three.
Luna for three, and it's good. Hey, she can sing the national anthem, and she can shoot it from the outside. Also, Misa Edwards is on the bench as well. Two usual starters are out. They'll dump it in. Nice pass. Ooh. Nice pass from Amber Crawford getting inside to number 23.
As
that
Tiara
was Tiara
Thompson.
Thompson. Gateway has a big team.
Mm. Oh, Parrish loses it.
And then Luna dives to the floor. Katia Luna. Oh, I'm sorry. That's Deborah Banks, the boss. Denise, can you hear me in your headset? We're good to go. As long as you can hear us.
It's good that we're just checking 2 minutes in that we're good to go.
I think she would have said something.
Yeah, probably.
Contractor inside, using her body. Can't get that one to fall. Way off. Rebounded was by Katrina Depew. Driving the lane, shooting it from the elbow. Getting it to roll is number three, Deja Lanier.
It's a real good movement getting around the defense, putting it up.
Yeah, nice little floater. Got the friendly bounce. Easton.
Banks just lost it.
Not sure why Deborah Banks is up there anyway, but she loses it out of bounds. 6-3 early.
Yeah, we usually see Deborah Banks in the corner under the basket.
Yeah, we usually see her in the paint or in the interior. Ooh, off the glass, no good. Oh. Gateway with the rebound. Getting it is Katrina DePue. Katrina DePue stands at 6 foot flat, and Tiara Thompson.
That is taller than me.
I think everybody on Gateway is taller than you.
Yeah, you're not.
Maybe
right.
except for Lauderdale Francois and Deja Lanier.
Yeah, we're the same height.
All right, for the first free throw, gets the bounce.
Gateway uses the Bayhawk bounce.
The Bayhawks bounce. All right, and she gets both free throws to go. And in the first few minutes, 8-3. Clock not moving up there. The game clock is not moving. Here we go. Got some extra time now. Here's Eason. Back to Luna for three. No good. Going up high. And they're going to say it's off the Bayhawks there. I thought that went off DePue, but they're going to say it went off Banks. Now they're going to say it's Gateway ball, and it should be. Nice afternoon, Saturday basketball, Craig. It's a good thing.
Waiting for the snow to melt.
God. Only to hit by more snow tomorrow, my friend, and the next day. And they're predicting another nor'easter.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. It's fun. Contractor gets the inbound pass back out to Eason. Eason over to Luna. Of course, she's going to shoot it for three. Bangs it home.
And why not shoot it for three? Brings it with him, too.
She does it all.
She can sing. She can shoot.
Shoot on the floor. She hustles.
That is the perfect woman.
Three-pointer from the corner. It's an air ball, but who's there to pick it up? No good. Oh, God, the trees.
Apparently everyone's there to pick it up.
More offensive opportunities, and DePue lays it in, finally.
Yeah, you can't let that happen, those second, third attempts.
Well, the Bayhawks right now, they have a lot of lack of height right now.
Yeah. That is true. Height will kill you in this game.
Eason for three. No good. Had a good look at it. Rebounded by Amber Crawford. Gateway Community College, based in New Haven, Connecticut. It's a long drive. Three-point shot. Way off. Not great outside shooting so far by Gateway, but they got the trees inside to get the rebound. That's for sure. And now that's Tiara Thompson, another six-footer.
Something interesting about this team is we talk about the Bayhawks, how every player seems to be spread out around the country, is the majority of this team, they're from Bridgeport, Connecticut. So this is definitely a team that's probably played together for a while.
Yeah, they're all homegrown. Yeah, a lot of Bridgeport, Connecticut, and New Haven. So maybe these girls, they might have played together in high school.
Or AAU or something.
AAU, youth basketball.
So this could be a team that knows each other very well.
Yeah, without a doubt. Gateway in that zone. Nice bounce pass by Parrish inside the contractor. Great execution on that one. Good job by Adia Contractor to go right up with that. Good hands. Good to see her score.
Crawford, and the ball has left the building.
And the ball has left the building. Game over.
Yeah. That was a good idea, just bad execution. The person down under, they weren't really in on the play and just overran it.
Yeah. Bad turnover by Gateway. And as much as BCC's been dominated on the boards, they only trail by 4 points. And they have three team fouls, 12-8. BCC hanging in there against Gateway. Katia Luna to inbound for Bristol. Oh, stolen. Ooh. Away.
Is that wingspan compared to Easton?
Yeah, DePue, the pass. Oh, missed. And then the putback by Tiara Thompson. Again, the offensive rebounds. BCC getting killed on the boards. Lucky to be in this one. Parrish for three. No good.
No good.
Front rim. Depew with the rebound. Leading the break. Gets the pass on the wing.
It's a good jumper by Crawford.
That's Amber Crawford, yes. She's a 5'7" guard. They get a tall team.
That they do.
From the free throw line, Deborah Banks with the jumper. It's nothing good. But net. Yeah. That's your girl, the boss.
Hey, it's a good catch. Quick release, in for two.
Ooh. They're going to call offensive. Banks on one end with the jumper that tickled the twine, and on the other end, taking the charge. Great hustle by Deborah Banks. Working both sides of the floor. Good job by her. Shannon Rhodes-Dillon and Misa Edwards on the watching from the bench today. Coach Moniz shaking things up in the corner. Banks.
No good.
Oh.
I'm sure as this game will go on, we'll see Misa Edwards and Shannon Rhodes-Dillon at some point. Definitely.
Oh, goodness gracious.
It's
rebound.
That again.
Katrina Depew gets the miss. Deja Lanier with a wild shot. But if I feel like, Craig, like the Gateway feels like they could throw anything up there, and they know their trees are going to go up and get it. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Like, we'll just throw it up at the rim and hope that one of our trees down there will grab the rebound and put it back in. Good strategy. Banks thought about it. Oh, tipped away by Depew. Parrish running with her. Depew with that high dribble. Whoa!
Megan Parrish getting in her face with a block.
Megan not scared.
Now, we've seen this from Megan Parrish plenty of times before. She does not care who her opponent is. She'll try as hard as she can every single time.
Yeah, she like pulled a LeBron, like trailing the play and swatting her, but...
Just denying Iguodala of a denying Iggy of a layup in the finals.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah. I remember I was rooting for the Warriors just because my friend was rooting for the Cavs. That's pretty much how it went. I didn't really care about basketball as much back then. So
when last year?
What? I really just got into basketball this year mostly.
Like this year?
Well, like after. After the finals last year is when I like actually started really like paying attention. I always knew like the rules of basketball and like who was good.
Yeah.
But now it's like
nice
actually
pass. Oh. Nice pass by Banks on the give and go, but Luna should have lost. She should have used the glass there.
No.
Going all the way down the other end is Amber Crawford.
It's fouling De'Asia Easton.
19-10 in the first quarter.
That's already Easton's third foul.
And Crawford will nail the first one.
And they realize that's Easton's third, so Misa Edwards coming into the game for the first time.
Yeah, she got her third. Surprised they waited that long. Now Misa Edwards will go in. 20-10. And Deja's going to be sitting there for a little bit now with three. Five team fouls by the home team. Second free throw made, 21-10. Megan Parrish bringing the ball up for the Bayhawks. Gateway in that 1-2-2 zone, yes. Ooh.
Saying it skipped out of bounds.
Yeah, bad pass by Luna.
I think Contractor should have picked it up.
Oh, wait a minute. They're going to say it went off Gateway.
Huh.
Went off someone's hand. Banks right away. Puts it above the glass.
Hey, Banks doing what she does best, banking it in.
And she did it. She grabbed that ball. You know what, Craig? She grabbed that ball, and she didn't put it to the floor. She got the ball up high, and she put it right up the glass.
Well, I talked about that earlier. She's got a quicker release now.
Yeah. She's not holding the basketball. Stolen away.
Ooh, Amber Crawford.
Amber Crawford steps into the passing lane, gets it to Lanier, lays it in on the left side. Good to go, 23-12 in Fall River. Bayhawks try not to let this game get away from them. Parrish for three from the wing, no good. Up to get it is DePue. Quickly out to the outlet, Lanier.
I can see DePue and Thompson getting a lot of rebounds in this game.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, look up, look up. Deborah Banks going to turn around there. Three, Edwards, no good.
Took like a weird bounce out of the side of the rim.
Yeah, that was a weird bounce. Crawford goes around the back there earlier. Jumper from the free throw line, no good. It's going to be off of Tiara Thompson. Going Bayhawks way. You're watching Bristol Community College Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media Channel 95 on your Comcast dial. It's David Cardoza and Craig Salvador here on the call. This game brought to you by FR Media and from Bristol Community College because Bristol. And also brought to you by the New England Patriots, the champions of Super Bowl 51 because.
Because of Tom Brady's
more.
Five rings.
Gets the rings.
The
Roger
the,
that.
And the best Super Bowl commercial ever. the MRI
that
one.
Yeah,
after.
That was after the Super Bowl. That yeah. was like after the game, right?
Still counts.
It's kind of new.
Still counts. Yeah, still it's kind of new. Anymore? It's kind of new.
It's kind of new. Oh, to get you a bigger locker.
See how this works. This means we're going to have to win again next year because if you remember when they won the first three, it was win one, miss one, win two, and now it was miss one.
They have a
win
chance
one,
to get
win another one.
Yeah, they have a chance to have a second dynasty within the dynasty. Three pointer, it's good. Katya
Luna
with her third
threes,
three.
Hitting threes left and right in this game.
Must be her birthday. No, she hits threes like that any day.
Yeah.
BCC trying to trap in the corner. Going underneath. Nice pass.
Oh, loses it.
Now it's knocked away. Parrish on the break. Driving all the way to her right. And they're going to call a reach in on Amber Crawford.
Yeah, that's Crawford second. Third for the team.
All right, 30-second timeout called by Gateway. And we'll take a little break here in the action. Bob Doss unhappy with his team, although their team's up 23-15, dominating on the offensive boards.
Yeah. Is that right? We said it's a height game at this point.
Sure is. But BCC hanging in there. If Katya Luna could keep shooting like that, she's the one that's kept the team in the game.
Well, that was something I was kind of thinking during that last play when Parrish was driving. She had Katya Luna on the far side, and Parrish has the passing ability. It seems like she could have maybe given it to her. But with this Gateway team, you know, we've seen them get steals out of nowhere, so
yeah,
she might have made
BCC
the right choice.
BCC should be quicker. Oh, another weird rebound. Parrish thought about it. Parrish stops at the free throw line, banks it home. I don't know if she called glass on that one, but BCC within six.
Less
55 seconds to play. Oh, Deborah Banks going to deny her. Gets the rebound anyways.
Yeah, Tiara Thompson with a magician act at that point. You know, I have no idea how she came up with that.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Banks looked to turn around for the free throw line. Up fake, no good. And they're going to call that foul on Deborah Banks.
Deborah Banks.
That's going to be her second. Shannon Rhodes still on the bench for Bristol. Shannon Rhodes steals the lead scorer on this BCC team. So she's still on the bench. She hasn't played 1 minute, so she can't be in foul trouble.
No, I feel like we're going to see in the second half a lot of her, though. You know,
maybe that's the strategy?
Yeah, get this game going, tire the other team out, then have a fresh Rosen steal out to absolutely dominate.
Yeah, maybe next year to keep Tom Brady fresh, maybe we'd put Jimmy Garoppolo in the first half and have Tom Brady be like a closer.
I love Jimmy G.
Like a Mariano Rivera. Jimmy G.
Yeah, Jimmy G is great. I really want him to stay.
He's just happy to be friends with Tom Brady.
I want him to stay, but he's a perfectly capable starter, so it's like another team can snatch him up so easily.
Nice bounce pass from Parrish. Gets it inside the contractor.
Yo, contractor getting it done.
He can definitely see the improvement by Adia.
Have to put up a buzzer beater.
Three-pointer. No, nothing doing.
Nope, we've only seen Megan Parrish with the end of the quarter three-pointers.
Yeah. And BCC ends the first quarter on a high note, 24-19. BCC within five. As we head into the second quarter now, after this game, we got the men's basketball team, the men's Bayhawks team, going against Gateway Community College. That is in the second part of our doubleheader.
Yep, bound to see an exciting game. We see both teams here supporting their women.
Yeah, they're all here watching Bayhawks basketball Saturday afternoons. Yeah, so BCC actually ended that.
Are you not recording?
I said BCC ended that quarter on a 7-0 run because it was 23-12. No, 7-1. Because it was 23-12 with a couple minutes left in the first quarter, and BCC had a little bit of a run there, so they closed the gap to within five. And that's it. What does BCC got to do to overtake Gateway? What are they going to do Craig, to out-duel their height, Gateway's height? What do they have to do to get around that right now?
With Gateway's height advantage, I think that the Bayhawks are going to have to find their shooters so they can take the shots, because they might not be able to win on a drive game, but when they do have to drive, they have to be able to be quick, get around them, because these guys, Gateway, they're tall, but they're also quick, so you got to be able to get around that. But I think find your shooters and be able to put it up. You know, seeing Luna put up a couple, Megan Parrish and Misa Edwards are fully capable. Deborah Banks is also doing her job under the net, and Adia Contractor, we've seen that too. So I think it's just going to turn into a shooting game at some point.
Well, that ball goes out of bounds. Oh, it's going to be Bayhawks basketball.
This is also a good thing they need to do is force them to make mistakes.
Definitely. I think BCC is a quicker team with Misa Edwards and Megan Parrish.
Oh, they're definitely quicker. It's the other team for having, like, all tall people. It's still right. They're quick.
They're not going to match up man. They're definitely not going to match up man to man.
No, definitely not.
But they got to work that zone to be smart. Here's Parrish. Over to Banks. Banks in the corner. Off the side of the rim. Crawford, 2-on-1. Putting it up is Lanier.
Almost lost it, but hung on to it.
Almost lost it, but she puts it up and in. 26-19. Banks always floating up top now.
Yeah, I was going to say, oh.
Ooh, almost stolen away by Depew. Loses it out of bounds back to the Bayhawks.
I was going to say, Banks in unfamiliar territory.
Yeah. Well, she's got a little jump shot from the free throw line in.
Well, this is kind of interesting because we're seeing her and Contractor at the same time. Usually we see them alternate.
Twin Towers. Edwards driving to her left. Puts it up, blocked by Depew. Loose ball. He's recovered by Lanier. Lanier in the open court. Bounce pass to Crawford. No, nothing doing. Rebounded and put back in by Tierra Thompson. All 6 foot of her. 28-19 now.
I was talking about a magician act earlier. That was the most unconventional, like, steal and pass I've ever seen. You see her, like, go around, and it just trickled off her hand.
Yeah. Banks turns around. Jumper. No good. That's a shot that she can hit, though. Inside that free throw line and in. Still, if you want to win this game, you can't depend on Deborah Banks to get your points right now. You got it. Shannon Rosenstiel is sitting back on the bench right now. Misa Edwards not doing much. Katya Luna is a great three-point shooter, but
she's not getting looks.
No, she's not getting looks. She's not getting a lot of looks. The looks that she's getting, she's made. But the ability to create your own shot and create offense. Oh, nice.
Ooh, Edwards getting aggressive.
Edwards getting feisty.
Gateway coach not Bob, pleased.
Bob Doss coaching. Oh, nice pass.
Ooh, swatted away.
They got Deborah Banks cut into the hole. They got her doing a lot of things. They got her coming up to the free throw line. She's definitely a moving piece. And she's going to go to the free throw line, so she's getting looks.
She can make this a seven-point game. She is an excellent three-point shooter.
But I think if they had Deborah Banks is like in the Shannon Rodensteel role where she's floating up to the top of the key, getting jump shots from out there, floating to the three-point line, just kind of being like a floater.
It's definitely interesting because we haven't really seen her in this role.
No. That ball spins out.
Nope. It's like the Falcons' hopes of the Super Bowl.
Oh, nice passing. Nice interior passing. The pass from Depew to Crawford. 30-20. Banks at the free throw line. Driving. Kicks it back out to Edwards. 4-3. No good. BCC not shooting good. Long pass. Oh, to Crawford. Touchdown. Lays it up and in.
Well, if Megan Parrish was an inch taller, she would have had that.
Well, that was a nice pass by Tiara Thompson. She looked like Tom Brady on that one.
We talked about before Megan Parrish not being afraid, but she's going to get the offensive foul.
And she has three. Megan Parrish has three, Craig, and Deja Edwards has three. That's Crawford, driving to her left, off the glass, and in. Amber Crawford getting into this game.
Not sure if she called glass either, but it worked.
I heard it. Again, we're bringing you this game from Bishop Conley High School. This is the home of the Bishop Conley High School Cougars and also the home of the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, right next door to the beautiful campus of Bristol Community College. They dump it in. And there's going to definitely be a foul committed there. They dump it into they're going to call an offensive foul.
It's just a jump ball.
Are they going to call a jump? It's a jump ball. Okay.
Yep, jump ball.
No fouls committed. Good job by BCC to grab a hold of that. Luna thought about three. Fakes the jumper. Get it inside.
That's a great
contractor.
Pass.
Ooh. Got to use that glass. Amber Crawford lays it in. Going the other way. Amber Crawford.
She's getting her game on.
Yeah, she is. She scored like the last 6 points for them. Luna. Three, no good. Depew with the rebound. Crawford around the back. She's got skills. Puts it up off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Thompson.
Almost
and that's it. You got to get a timeout now. Serge Moniz is going to call a timeout. 30-second timeout here on the court. 38-20. And, Craig, what the hell just happened? The BCC was just down five. It was 24-19. And now the Gateway Community College on a 14-1 run to open up the second quarter with 6 minutes and 7 seconds to play.
What happened? Amber Crawford happened. All of a sudden now she's making her shot. She's driving. You saw those ridiculous handles.
She likes to go around the back.
Yeah.
She's kind of flashy.
Very impressive.
Yeah, 38-20. What a whirlwind. We're less than 4 minutes in. And Gateway has been, like, scoring in a flurry. Again, a 14-1 run to open up the second quarter. It was 24-19 at the end of the first quarter, if you just join us. Again, Gateway in that zone. BCC having a – oh, nice pass again. This time Contractor showing good hands. She can't connect on that one. It was a nice pass by Parrish. Three-pointer Lanier. No good. Again, rebounded by Thompson. They just don't have an answer for that height.
No. We're talking about the passes to Audia Contractor. She's kind of having the same problem that Deborah Banks used to have. She's bringing the ball down right away instead of putting it up
right.
real quick.
She's showing good hands when she's getting those passes. And she's showing good ability to go right up with it, but at the same time, she's not being consistent. Three-point shot. Crawford misses. Again, Thompson underneath there again. To Pugh with the rebound. Yeah, they're just dominating on the boards.
It's just the height. No, you look at the rebounders, it's literally just Katrina DePue and Tiara Thompson.
Just getting all the rebounds. They're not always doing a good job of putting it back in, by the way.
No, but they keep getting it.
Right. Three-pointer by Lanier from the wing. No good.
Just wide.
Goodness gracious. DePue over the back. And they're going to call a blocking foul. They're going to call it an Adia Contractor. That's going to be her first. Coach Moniz, you don't hear a word. You don't hear a peep out of this guy. Coach Bob Doss over there for Gateway. He's constantly chirping.
It's funny as how he's chirping and they're winning by this much.
Exactly.
It's kind of interesting that Gateway on the foul shots, they just stay back rather than want to get an offensive rebound.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's confidence in their shooters or just wanting to get back on defense.
Oh, you mean at the free throw line?
Yeah.
Well, they're up 19.
True.
Just, you know. Probably don't feel like crashing the boards on the at the free throw line at this point. And their bench is very limited right now, so try not to tire out. Deja Easton's going to come in for Misa Edwards right now. That's Deja Edwards, number 10. We get a timeout on the floor. I think that timeout's going to be on Gateway, for Gateway. Coach Bob Doss using his timeouts smartly. He's only got five players. I don't believe he subbed once. Or he's got a couple players that haven't suited up today.
Not sure why that is, but whatever the reason, like we said, just playing with five players.
Anyway, Craig, why don't you tell our fans where they can find a lot of our telecasts on YouTube.
If you go to youtube.com/Bristol Community College, you can find all of our games. You can listen to me and Dave's lovely voices all day long as much as you want, because they will get posted a couple days after the broadcast goes up.
Listen to them on Valentine's Day. If you want to listen to our lovely voices.
Yep. Let's soothe you with our basketball knowledge.
And you can also listen to my podcast on Tuesday on bccradio.org at 4 p.m. It's our championship edition of the Dirty Water Sports Hour with myself, Dave Cardoza, and Benjamin Farabini of FR Media. It's the Dirty Water Sports Hour, 4 p.m. It's our championship edition as we commemorate the New England Patriots' great magical season, their historic comeback, and we bring you all the sounds of Super Bowl 51 and more. Listen at 4 p.m. on bccradio.org on Tuesday.
I'm sure you'll be talking about how there's little to absolutely no doubt now Tom Brady is the greatest quarterback.
Oh, yeah, we're going to have a funeral for the debates. The casket, we're putting a final nail in the casket, a final nail in the coffin for who the greatest coach, quarterback, and team is of all time.
Did you see what Joe Montana said?
Oh, the three-pointer by Parrish. BCC needed that. Yes, I did, and he's delusional.
Well, I feel like he's got to swallow his pride at that point.
Just like Brandon Marshall saying that J.J. Watt is the best player of all time.
J.J. Watt hasn't been around enough to be
no, it's just,
considered that
it's just
yet.
People being stupid.
Yeah.
41-24, Gateway with another score. Parrish tees it up from the corner. Man, Easton is there to get the air ball. Luna for three. That's no good. Banks going to save it. She stepped out of bounds.
Yeah. Haven't seen a lot of scoring from Megan Parrish this game.
No, not having her best game, that's for sure. Oh, the pass by Depew. Tried to get inside to Lanier. Goes off her hands.
Seen that happen a couple times. Sometimes you just got butterfingers.
BCC not playing spirited basketball. They look tired and disinterested.
Break from the Super Bowl might have hurt them.
Edwards driving. Kicks it to Luna. Thought about it. Gets it inside. Banks turns around. Off the glass. No good. Good looking play. Just couldn't execute it.
I feel like we've been saying that a lot for the Bayhawks this game.
And that's a travel. I'm going to call steps on Depew. 41-24. 3 minutes and 26 seconds to the half. I don't know. You know, I don't know what's going on the sideline. I don't know what's going on with this picture over here with Shannon Rhodes still on the bench. Suited up, but on the bench.
I don't know. Like I said, might save her, get out of foul trouble, save her for the second half. It's pretty much all I can think of. I don't know. It doesn't really appear anything's wrong with her. I don't think she's sick or anything.
Again, BCC going through a coaching change, going through a transition. A couple weeks ago, Coach Serge Moniz replaced Coach Aaron Morrell. And that's all we know. For three, Luna drains it home. Down the drain. Big shot there. They needed that one. Katia Luna's fourth.
That is the power of America from singing the national anthem.
The power of making America great again?
I wouldn't go there, but.
Making BCC great again. On the inside.
We just elected a new president for BCC, didn't we?
No politics, Craig.
Yeah, no. This is sports. This is where we get away from it.
The people are going to find you and lynch you.
Hey, you're the one who said make America great again.
Three-pointer is Edwards for three.
I'm just saying that was Katia Luna's American will to make that three.
It's just lingo.
Yeah.
That's all it is. That was a big three by Edwards. Cut the lead to 13. Lanier, the jumper, sinks it home. It's good.
Lanier taking it right back.
Good response by Lanier. 45-30, under 2 minutes to play in the half. Oh, bounce
that was a
pass.
Mistake. Lazy pass.
Telegraph that one. Nice bounce pass there to Crawford. Back to Thompson. Steps out of bounds. I think Thompson might have been better off taking that all the way to the rack.
Well, if she did, I don't know who would have been able to stop her.
Nobody.
Nobody.
It's funny, they get the ball to Banks, and they don't even collapse on her. Easton for three, no good. Banks has no chance underneath there. There's the outlet pass all the way down to Lanier. Lays it through. Pass from Thompson. 47-30, just like that. It's back to a 17-point game. Edwards, ooh, in the corner. Parrish tried to save it. Now it's a jump ball.
Edwards is down. She's getting up, though. It's good.
Frustrating first half for the Bayhawks, then.
Definitely.
First home games since after the break. Well, not since after the break, but first home game of February.
Yeah, we were supposed to have one on Tuesday, but due to the weather, nope.
Due to that.
It's like, you know.
Due to that finicky New England weather, driving the lane, floating it up is Crawford. And they're going to call a foul. On Crawford.
The finicky New England weather where it was 50 the day before and then it snowed.
It was like
foot.
60 the day before. Then all of a sudden we had a blizzard.
It's like spring. People could wear shorts outside.
Did you notice that during that blizzard it was thundering at one point?
Yeah, I saw. I was like, what?
I didn't know if it was thundering or if it was an earthquake. Easton gets the rebound. No good.
I don't think we've said that once this game.
What, Easton gets the rebound?
Yeah. Think about it. She's the shortest person on our team their team.
She's fun-sized.
Fun-sized. That's what I say, too.
She's fun-sized. Yeah.
Also, something interesting with this Gateway team, made up of pretty much all sophomores. The only freshman for this team is Amber Crawford.
Yeah, definitely an experienced team. They're all sophomores. Deep into February, they've been playing with each other for a little bit. As for BCC, they're all freshmen. This is a BCC team. This is a BCC program that missed last year. They didn't have enough players. So the fact that they even have a team this year is brilliant. Parrish sinks both free throws. BCC going to have a much better second half.
Yep. Only down by 15, though. They can do it.
They're going to have to limit the mistakes, Greg, if they want to get back in this one right now.
Hopefully we can see Shannon Rosensteel get in it.
Ooh, Depew loses that. Crawford, deep three, no good. They are getting every single rebound. It's absolutely ridiculous. You've got to box out. You've got to put a body on someone. Depew with the rebound and the putback. BCC will hold for the last shot here. Edwards from the jumper. The jumper from the line is good. And that's going to close out the first half from Bishop Conley. So at the half right now, it's 49-34. Gateway Community College from New Haven, Connecticut has come here, and they get a 15-point lead here at the halftime. Here at halftime at Bishop Conley, you're watching Bayhawks basketball. Stay tuned for the second half action. All right, welcome back, everybody. It's David Cardoza. I'm alongside here with the Portuguese Cowboy, Craig Salvador. What's going on, Craig?
No comment.
Well, welcome everybody back to Bishop Conley High School. Your Bristol Community College Bayhawks trail Gateway Community College 49-34 at the half. So the story of the first half is really the boards, where BCC has really failed to come up with the boards. Tiara Thompson and Katrina Depew have really dominated on the boards. They've really dominated on the interior. They're both 6 foot. They're both 6 feet, respectively. And here we go. Second half underway. Deja Easton with the miss. And again, as I said before, Tiara Thompson is getting all the rebounds.
Still interesting to see if that start in the second half. Shannon Rosensteel is still not in this game.
And again, we're not sure what the reason is. I guess we're not privy to all that.
I'm not exclusive enough to get this information.
Parrish from the wing, 3-point shot. Nothing but air. Come on, Megan. BCC really needs Megan Parrish to step up in this second half. It's a 15-point lead. It's not like we've seen comebacks before, Craig. Anything can happen.
Seen comebacks in the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, definitely. Be inspired. I don't see any inspiration going on. Oh, a nice dish. Oh, my goodness.
That was pretty.
Count it.
That was pretty.
Depew gets it inside to Lanier. Lanier dishes off to it gets it inside to Crawford, and then Crawford with the dish to Lanier. Beautiful passing.
And starting this out, Megan Parrish now is her fourth foul.
They finally put the 2 points up there, 51-34. Again, Shannon Rosensteel on the bench from the beginning, and Megan Parrish will sit.
Misa Edwards is in for her.
Misa Edwards is in, 52-34.
It's just been kind of an off game for the Bayhawks.
Banks in the corner. Kicks it back out to Luna. Luna's going to tilt it up there. Short. Rebounded by Lanier. Lanier in the corner. Throws it back out to try to get it down court to Crawford. Stolen by Edwards.
Edwards playing like a cornerback in that play.
It looked like a safety. Ooh, Edwards wills her way into the paint, shoots a short jumper, and connects. Again, I'm Cardoza. He's Salvador, along with DP on the camera work.
Coming at you live from the sweat box.
You know, Denise is always emailing. She's always got like all kinds of emails that I get. She sends like those group emails.
Well, I had to see if we had a game today, so. So I didn't know if it was going to get canceled.
I don't get anybody else's emails besides.
I don't usually send them. I usually just send to Keith if I'm not able to make it.
Short jumper. Crawford.
Oh, still good.
Crawford's able to just do a shooting drill. She just walks up, shoots a 15-foot jumper, and nails it. No Bayhawks defenders in her face.
No, Bayhawks not that great on defense today. Oh, Easton came down with
Coach
it.
Coach Serge Moniz assists there with his hands in his pockets. Front row seat for him.
It's the other problem with Bayhawks. They're just not really making their shots.
It's a layup drill. Lanier lays that in. And Lanier's been sneaky good. We talk about the trees. We talk about Thompson and DePue, but Lanier has really stepped up. Along with Crawford.
Especially Lanier, one of the shortest person on the team.
Here's Lanier again on the break. Deborah Banks looked like she wanted a driller, but.
No, just stopped in her tracks.
Gateway just playing more inspired basketball, more enthusiastic, more fired up, more energy.
It's more everything.
More a lot of things,
more scoring,
yes.
More points.
And it's 58-36. It was.
A lot more rebounds.
Yeah, to say the least. It was 24-19 at the end of the first quarter, and since then, here comes my fuzzy math. Gateway has scored 34 points since then. 34-17 since the first quarter.
We're broadcasters, Dave. We don't need math.
It's all right. Well, when you don't have statisticians,
yeah,
to bring us regular stats, anyway. 58-36. We're getting close towards tournament time. In a couple weeks, the MCAC. That miss was by Contractor. Going back the other way. Oh, driving the lane. Strong lays it in. Nobody was going to stop her on that. That's Katrina DePue. Jumper, Contractor. Contractor playing a quietly good game. Nice jumper there. She's a lot of improvement by her. She looks like a new player.
Hmm. She's getting looks, making shots. Guess there's going to be any bright spots in this game.
If there's any bright spot, it's been Adia Contractor. And Katia Luna with her performance. Yeah. Everybody else is asleep.
Yeah.
Jumper, no good by Lanier.
Banks almost had the rebound, couldn't hang on.
Nope. But who else gets it? Tiara Thompson. Yep.
Looks like she's got her knee pads. Looks like dual knee braces, Stone Cold Steve Austin style.
It is WrestleMania season. Crawford, three-pointer, drains it home.
It's Amber Crawford again.
This one's on the verge of getting ugly.
The most neutered defense chant I have ever heard in my life.
The most what?
Neutered defense chance.
Neutered?
It's just the men's team, but it was only like five of them.
You say men's and neutered at the same time. So you're basically saying our men's basketball team is neutered.
No, not ours. Ours aren't even here. I don't know where they are. I'm talking the other team.
Oh, yeah.
I don't even know where our team is.
Getting ready for the game. Halfway through this third quarter, 25-point lead for Gateway. Gateway looking like the Golden State Warriors.
They got the
colors. Their uniforms. Look at the passing. Oh, but they're going to call a. Oh, my goodness.
It's like a running knee.
A lot of great passing there, but they're going to call an offensive foul, and Adia Contractor is the one that picked up the charge. She's been playing a good game, I'm telling you. Mm. AC. AC keeping it cool.
I mean, we had to think of other nicknames for people.
Yeah. AC.
I was thinking AD for a second, Anthony Davis. I don't know why.
Anthony Davis.
Is there still trade talk with him and the Celtics?
It's not going to happen, buddy.
We just need someone with Isaiah Thomas. He can't be our only scorer.
Well, as Avery Bradley continues to sit on the to be hurt.
Yeah.
Short jumper. Nails it.
Ooh, nice.
Edwards. Edwards hitting some jumpers. She's getting in on it.
Yeah, she had a slow start at the beginning of the game, but she's starting to settle down.
Well, she usually doesn't come off the bench, so.
Yeah.
BCC in 2-3 zone. They jump it in. They get inside. Thompson puts it up off the glass. No good. Rebounded is Depew.
Well, looks like she hurt her ankle.
I think she's going to walk it off. She's going to shake it off. 63-40.
At least not a good block, but couldn't do anything.
No good. Thompson, the Twin Towers. Goodness gracious. No answer. BCC just has no answer.
Nope.
In the corner, Edwards. Jumper is no good. Rebounded by Banks. Puts it in off the glass and rolls it home. Gateway slowing the game down now. Lanier directing traffic. They'll dump it in.
He's playing some around the world now.
3-point shot.
Wow. Katrina Depew with a 3-point shot. I haven't seen that.
Extending the floor to Depew. They threw it around the world. Been around the world and aye. Edwards cut to the hole. Banks should have threw it to her. She should have passed it. Edwards, bounce pass back to Luna. Luna from the top for three. No good. Oh, another nice pass there by Thompson.
Crawford has that. Oh, no.
Lanier is there.
I was about to say Crawford has that all day, but she just missed it.
I know. She fumbled the ball out of the end zone. Nice pass there. Thompson is showing all of her skills. Rebounded on the inside. Passing ability, shooting it from the outside all day long.
All day, every day.
Every damn day.
All of the lights, all of. I got that Gatorade commercial stuck in my head. They're like, you know the one I'm talking about? They're singing All of the Lights. And they have
Was that during the Super Bowl?
Probably.
It's
been on for a while, but they're like eating something. It's like a Gatorade's protein bar.
My commercial game is not on point lately, Craig.
It's like they play ads, like you can see on YouTube, especially if you're checking Bristol Community College basketball on YouTube, youtube.com/Bristol Community College. You can listen to me and Dave Cardoza as much as you want.
That's it. BCC Athletics. Luna for three. She's kind of gone cold. Contractor getting in there. Contractor wants more. Rebound by Banks. In the lane. Nope. No good.
Nope. Thompson got the rebound on that one.
AD is definitely trying, and that's probably why she's out there. But still, Shannon Rodensteel not playing.
Contractor just drew a foul. Only her second. See Megan Parrish not in this game. She's in foul trouble. She got into foul trouble. She had three pretty much right off the bat in the first quarter.
But the thing is, like, the time is running out. It doesn't matter. You need your best players out there. You're down 70-42. Hits Edwards off. In the open floor with DJ Eason. Eason back out to Edwards for three. Good. Those two become a little bit of a duo. A nice pass by Eason to find Edwards.
It's just good to see DJ Eason back in the game.
Yeah, she's moving pretty well. Yep. She looks good.
Yeah.
As the season goes on, hopefully she'll get more and more back acclimated. This is a well-rounded Gateway team. They have a short bench, or should I say no bench, but they have a great starting five. They're going to be a force to be reckoned with in the regional tournament. They're getting inside of Banks. Banks using her body and gets it up over Thompson.
That's what you got to do. Talking about boxing out, good job using the body. Step back, put up, two.
Yep. Three-point shot by Lanier. Coming off, rebounded by Banks. Here's Misa Edwards driving, short jumper. That's been her bread and butter today. Can't get it to fall.
It looked like she was going to go for a layup, but she made the right move going for a jump shot.
Oh, look at that pass by Crawford on the lay-in to Thompson.
I wanted her to dunk it.
Gateway looking good, 72-47. You see a post by Edelman and Amendola today. They're in a car. They're rapping. It's like, I'm balling.
Is this
just like I play for New England?
No, I feel like this is on Jules' YouTube account.
I just seen it today.
He does something like a few years ago he did like smoothie time and burger time, and then he just did parade time.
Parade time.
Yeah, like he brought on. This is like back when like Chandler Jones played with us. Like he'd do smoothie time. Chandler Jones and
smoothie time.
Yeah, they just make smoothies and talk about whatever.
No, I did not see that.
Yeah. No, my favorite is it's like Julian Edelman has his own talk shows, a short, and he's like, I think this is when he had Chandler Jones on, and he thought it was John Bones Jones, his brother.
He thought it was?
No. That's the skit, is that he thinks that he's talking to John Bones Jones. And Chandler's just like, Julian, I'm your teammate. We had practice this morning.
I did not see that.
Yeah, it was a few years ago. But he's like asking questions, and he's like going really in detail about this one thing. And I forget what the question was, but then he just goes, now, knowing all this knowledge, who's the best-looking punt returner in the National Football League? He's just looking at him, waiting for Chandler Jones to say Julian Edelman.
But he doesn't.
No, he just kind of looks at the cameras like, you serious?
Did not see that.
It's pretty funny.
72-47. Yes, it's a basketball game.
Yeah, you know that when we're talking about Julian Edelman's YouTube account.
Yeah. And Instagram and everything else.
Yep. Everyone follow Julian Edelman. He's forever my favorite football player now. Because he helped me get me my license.
Luna's going to travel here. Back to Gateway.
That's actually a funny story. I'm going to have to tell it if I ever go on your show, is how Julian Edelman helped me get my license.
How did Julian Edelman help you get your license?
Yep.
Your driver's license?
Yep. It's a funny story. If like I said, if I ever appear on
Save
your
show. Save it for the show.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If I ever appear on your show, I'm going to have to tell it then.
Definitely got to.
I don't give this stuff out for free.
Shot clock winding down. 1 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. And it lays it up and in. Doesn't matter, Lanier.
Do it.
Edwards going to have to throw it up there. Too late. Way too late. 74-47 at the end of three. So the Gateway Community College is coming here. And after a tight first quarter, they really, really have put the boots to the Bayhawks, if you will.
We'll talk about Gateway only have five players, but they have no intention of slowing down.
What is BCC's problem, Craig? What is the problem?
Their star players are just going cold. That's kind of it. We haven't seen a big game from Megan Parrish, and she's in foul trouble. Misa Edwards having an off game. Katia Luna's still shooting threes, but she's not getting a lot of looks. Deborah Banks doing as best she can. Audia Contractor actually stepping up, which is good for her, but it hasn't been enough.
Definitely showing a lot of improvement, especially when she gets the ball on the inside, putting it up and in, showing good hands, getting good position down there. She also had a jumper from the free throw line. She's got about 6 points today. But Megan Parrish is not playing like Megan Parrish. We haven't seen her even shoot as much. She's been way out of it. And so, I mean, we're usually seeing her good for like 15 points, 20 points, somewhere around there. And Shannon Rodensteel, who was dressed today. But all we just seen her on the bench. And we're not sure why. You know, there's no explanation. She is dressed. They could use her. She's one of the top scorers of Region 21. She's their top rebounder. She's their best player. She's their best all-around player. And they could have used her today, but, you know, it's a coach's decision. You know, not sure what it could be. So.
And Deja Easton, her first game back. So
yeah,
maybe a little rusty from the concussion.
I was looking forward to for them to have a full squad today and hang in there against this pretty good Gateway team. Back it in. It's Hugh. Banks giving everything she got. And they're going to call a travel. She got that up off the glass.
I was going to say, how did that fall?
I don't know. Gateway with their height, I mean, they're going to be right in there. Roxbury is the number one team in the country. They're the number one team in Region 21. They could probably get Roxbury a go. Just with their height alone. Jumper from the elbow, no good. Easton misses. Here comes Crawford, looks ahead, has it. Oh, couldn't put it in, Thompson. She was kind of following her momentum, was taking her out of bounds, and she couldn't get enough mustard up off the glass.
Yep. Looking like Chris Hogan with that receiving skill, though.
Chris Hogan, you and Hogan.
Hey, I love Chris Hogan.
Danny Amendola said he was the most messed up out of all his buddies there after the Super Bowl.
Oh, really?
Amendola was on Jimmy Kimmel.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah.
And then
He was doing some questionable things.
Oh, really?
His behavior was kind of questionable.
What, during the game or after the
game? After the game.
Oh.
When they were, like, partying.
Yeah.
Amendola was hanging out with Snoop Dogg. Jumper.
Okay,
no good.
I see where you're going. Well, Megan Parrish is
crossing over.
Ready.
Misa Edwards has space. That did not go in.
Nope.
Rebounded by Depew.
That was interesting. Megan Parrish is getting ready to come back in the game. I think my favorite thing during the parade was when Gronk had the trophy. He like talked to whoever was holding the trophy. He's like, "Hey, let me see that." He grabbed it, held it up. Whole crowd starts cheering, and he just says, "I didn't even play, and they're cheering for me."
when was this?
During the parade. Gronk was holding up the trophy at some point.
No, I believe he said he came into the parade with no intentions of partying or doing anything, but he said. The fans wanted him to, so he said he wanted to get the fans what they wanted to see. Deja Easton goes and lays it in. All right. This is not Patriots Weekly, and we swear. This is Bristol Community College.
We're just trying to cheer
basketball.
Ourselves up with this from this game.
Driving, getting into the teeth of the defense. Can't get it to go. Rebound. Depew. Depew gets her own miss, puts it back up and in, and that's been the story. Has been the second and third and fourth and fifth opportunities for Gateway. Luna thought about three, gets it to Easton. From the top of the key, gets it to roll.
Easton and doing some work now.
Easton with back-to-back baskets.
Fouls on Easton. I believe that's her fourth.
Lanier, deep three, drains it home. Looking like Steph Curry out there in her Golden State uniform.
Hey, number
Gateway
three.
State.
Number three, not too far off from number 30.
Yeah. Driving. Oh, look at Easton. Easton showing some speed. Some quickness.
Talk about the Steph Curry action. Easton with the IT action.
The IT action. Like you said, football season is over. What do we do now with our lives?
Watch the Celtics as their second place in the Eastern Conference. So,
which is kind of surprising. They're actually like
two games
back of Cleveland.
Cleveland hasn't been doing the best. And no one wants
to. Well, because it's because they're bored.
LeBron's trying to recruit people, and it's not working.
15 on the shot clock. It looks they get it inside. They pound it inside, and her body.
These rebounds are getting ridiculous.
It's sickening. 81-51, 30-point lead. BCC getting blown out of their own gym. Driving the lane. Puts it up off the glass, and that's the Megan Parrish we're used to. Yep. Megan Parrish going over Depew with that one. I feel like Depew is not giving her all on defense anymore. She's just kind of putting the hands up.
I mean, like if she's you so tall, it might work.
Yeah. Lanier, the three.
Yeah, see, look, not even trying and gets the rebounds.
Oh, but taken away by Edwards.
Now Banks trying to
and
get
now
it.
And now Banks. Banks showing some feistiness. Yep.
So they call a jump ball. It's going to be Bayhawks ball.
Cold and slushy and snowy outside, but it's warm inside in this gym as we're getting ready for the Bayhawks men's team going against Gateway. Men's team ranked number one in the region, in the conference. Lanier gets the outlet. Nice dish to Crawford.
Crawford was not expecting that.
No, she couldn't hold on to it. Parrish better watch out. She had Easton behind her. Cross-court pass. Luna thought about three. Brings it in from the elbow. Jump shot. Good.
Easton. Thought about three, but we'll take two.
Luna.
Fueled by the power of America.
Don't start. Gateway has good, they have good swift passing.
A foul on Deborah Banks.
And she's going to foul out of the ball game. And now they're going to put Shannon Rhodes still in.
Kind of strange that they are waiting this long and only when one of the big contributors now has been fouled out.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's kind of interesting in what can pretty much kind of be considered a lost game at this point. Classy.
And he's going to hand the coach back her snotty snot rag.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's dedication to your team.
You're a good man, coach.
You've earned my respect today.
Yeah. I don't think so.
I don't know.
That's a lie. Parrish.
I like when we can make friends during these.
Edwards lays it in. Edwards has looked stronger as the game gone on. But I think Gateway really kind of sit back with kind of a vanilla cupcake defense right now, too. I don't think they're playing their, you know, most intense defense right now.
Yeah, that, and I think Gateway really just took BCC out of their game early on.
Yeah, they kind of, if I was Shannon Rhodes, I would just keep the ball. See, they could have used her. Even though I know she missed that, but they could just use her height, too. On the other end, Lanier with the pass from Thompson. 85-57. This one's almost over from Conley.
Well, with four painful minutes remaining. But Megan Parrish easing the pain, 2 points.
Megan Parrish hits a lot of shots off the glass from, like, the front end. It's from like the front of the basket.
Yeah, you don't see that too often.
No. Oop. Crawford throws right into the hands of Rodensteel. Here's Parrish driving. Gets it blocked, by J. Pugh.
And she caught it.
Yes, she did.
That's a bad pass.
4-on-1. Execute that. You got to execute a 4-on-1. Come on now. Parrish jumper.
That was just not good.
No, that's not good. You got a 4-on-1. You got to score the basketball. That's how you know it's just not your day.
Nope. You had all of Gateway back just not doing anything.
Shannon inside an 80-year contractor off the glass and in. And I'm going to call this right now before we go off the air, before we even begin to go off the air. 80-year contractor is my Bayhawks player of the game.
I will agree with that. I just want Tierra Thompson or Katrina Dupuy to either. I just want one of them to dunk.
It's not going to happen.
Come on.
It's not.
Okay, one will boost the other, and then they'll dunk.
See, because they may look tall to you, and they may sound tall to you, but they're only 6 foot.
Yeah, I know.
They were like 6'5", 6'6". Just a 6 foot woman is just not dunking the basketball, Craig. It's just not going to happen.
I can dream.
Dream.
With a game like this, it'd just be exciting if it could happen. I know it won't, but.
Bring the house down?
Yeah. Get the crowd going.
Capacity crowd of 9. Capacity crowd of 11, I'm sorry. On hand for this one.
Most of it was the boys, the men's team from both schools, and now they're
I'm looking
gone.
At it right now. 2, 5, 7, 8, 11.
11.
Here's Parrish driving. Nice bounce pass. Rodensteel. Bang. Mm. See if you had a little bit more of that all game.
Be a little 85
closer. 85 to 63.
Okay. Gateway is going to have a massive collapse like the Falcons.
Now Coach Moniz wants to coach.
Well, that just happened.
Gateway stalling the basketball right now. Nice pass inside to Thompson. The pass from Depew.
Good job going to her left. 87
to 63.
Tara Thompson just says nope.
Edwards from the corner. Three-pointer. No good. Rebounded by Contractor. Oh, go back up with it. There you go.
Contractor gives Gateway a taste
of
their own medicine.
Contractor's in double figures for the day. Haiti has got her heart in it. She's in it to win it today.
This might be her highest scoring game we've seen.
Oh, without a shadow of a doubt is. I feel like BCC just started to play.
Yeah, maybe if this game went on another hour, we could come back.
3-point shot. Was that Lanier?
That was Lanier.
This is the first I've heard BCC talk and get and play spirited.
That's like, with a minute 20
I don't
left
understand.
In the game. Now Megan
now,
Parrish is making
shots. Now all of a sudden they want to play? Is it because they got their best player out there? I'm not sure.
Maybe.
This is just. You haven't played with any spirit or fight the whole game, and all of a sudden now you're trying to communicate and talk and play with some energy.
That was
a pass. It's a minute left in the game.
And they're just 90. Holding it.
Spinning, losing it, but it puts it up and in. Depew. She's been a star for today. She has been a star. 92 to 67. Katia Luna for 3, no good. Rosensteel jumper from the free throw line, no good. Luna for three. Good. Another three by her. It's like, do they have some kind of a bet? How many threes can you hit? What's going on?
How many did Steph Curry hit? He had 13 in a game once. That's his high, that's like NBA highest.
You might be right. Katya Luna has 5 threes today.
She could definitely have more, but she wasn't getting too many looks this game.
Yeah. That's going to do it.
The final
seconds. Gateway is going to run the clock out. And Gateway beats your Bristol Community College Bayhawks here at Bishop Connolly High School. 92-70 is the final. So Gateway comes in here. One of the top teams in Region 21. They're going to be a team to look out for as we reach the state tournament and the Region 21 tournament in late February, early March. So for Dave Cardoza and Craig Salvador, the Bayhawks lose 92-70. Adia Contractors are a Bayhawks player of the game. She had 10 points. And I felt that she was Bristol Community College's most consistent player and definitely more improved since we've seen last time. So for Cardoza, Craig, and DP, you've been watching Bayhawks basketball. Stay tuned for the men's Bayhawks basketball team, BCC, going up against Gateway Community College. See you later.